Okay, the next thing that we need to do is to solve for v0 minus as a function of v0 plus. We're going to solve for v0 minus, and what we'll find it is the zl minus z0 over zl plus z0 times v0 plus. Just take this equation and solve for v0 minus, that's what you'll get. Another way to write that is that v0 minus divided by v0 plus is zl minus z0 over zl plus z0. We call this the voltage reflection coefficient because it's telling us how much voltage is reflected dependent on how much voltage is transmitted. It's a very important factor, and it's equal to negative the current reflection coefficient. So if we go back to our equation where we said that V of Z is V0 plus e to the minus j beta z plus V0 minus, but instead of V0 minus, let's use gamma V times V0 plus e to the plus j beta z. This is another, sorry about moving that backwards. This is a very common, slightly different version of the same equation. Then I of Z is equal to V0 plus divided by Z0 times e to the minus j beta z minus the voltage reflection coefficient times V0 plus divided by Z0 e to the plus j beta z. Now let's consider what this reflection coefficient means. Let's suppose, for instance, that we have a characteristic impedance on our transmission line of 100 ohms and that we connect it to a 50 ohm load. In that case, the reflection coefficient is going to be ZL minus Z0 over ZL plus Z0, of course. So that's going to be 50 minus 100 divided by 50 plus 100, or minus 1/3. That means that if I'm propagating a 1 volt incident wave, that my V0 minus is going to be minus 1/3. So as it comes back this direction, it's going to have a magnitude, actually from 0, of 1/3, and it's going to be 180 degrees out of phase from the original wave. Now let's see what would happen if we had an open circuit. In that case, ZL would be infinity, and the reflection coefficient would be infinity minus Z0 over infinity plus Z0. Z0 is very small compared to infinity, so we can ignore it in both cases, and we get a magnitude of 1. That means that all of the voltage that hits the end of an open circuit is reflected back. Ooh, and it's in phase, so let's see what happens. Right here, when I get to the end of my transmission line, let's let that be my open circuit. This is the V0 plus. All of that is reflected back. Here comes my reflected wave. It's perfectly in phase, and it has the same magnitude as it did, as the V0 plus did. Now remember that the total wave is the sum of the two. So when I add these up, it's a magnitude of 2, magnitude of negative 2, magnitude of 2, magnitude of negative 2, and so on. The total voltage, V total, is actually V0 plus plus V0 minus, but that's 1 times V0 plus, or 2 V0 plus for the case of an open circuit. That means the voltage really did double. Now let's see what would happen if we had a short. When we have a short, the load is 0. So with the reflection coefficient is 0 minus Z0 over 0 plus Z0, and that is minus 1. That means that for a short circuit, all of the voltage is reflected back, but it's reflected back out of phase. And let's see what happens there. So here was my original V0 plus that gets to the end of the transmission line, V0 plus, and my reflected wave, same magnitude, but out of phase. So the sum of these two ends up being 0 here, but it doesn't stay 0 everywhere. It goes kind of like this. But it starts out with 0, goes up to a magnitude of 2, down to the magnitude of 2, and so on and so forth. I hope that you watch the standing wave video.